Z-Image Turbo is an amazing new image model that was just released by the team at Alibaba. It runs well on low-power GPUs and produces phenomenal results. While the open source community is eagerly awaiting the base model to come out, which will likely produce even better results when training LoRAs and checkpoints, here's how you can train a LoRA with this distilled model today. So to get started, I'm going over to RunPod and I'm going to deploy a RTX 5090 that's sufficient for training this model. Now you want to make sure that you change out the template to the Ostris template just by simply searching that within the search bar and make sure it's this Ostris AI Toolkit latest. Click that. Make sure that you have enough space on the disk. The default should be fine. And then just simply click deploy on demand. All right, so here's the Ostris AI Toolkit. I already have a job running, but we'll go ahead and create another one. So simply click on datasets and click on new datasets. So we're going to give this dataset a name. I'm just going to give it a generic name here. So I named it teacher with a 3 as the second to last word. And then let me bring in some images. So these 9 images I used to train a Flux LoRA. So we're just kind of reusing these ones. And now you can add a caption if you want to the data set. However, I'm not going to worry about that. Now we're going to create a new job. So let me just set the training name and the trigger word. Now, as far as the model architecture, we'll want to select Z-Image Turbo with the training adapter. Now, you'll see the training adapter path, I just want to quickly note, is the creator of this application. Just noted that they're testing out a new training adapter. So if you want to test that, say within the next week or two, just simply change this out from a V1 to a V2. Now, as far as the data sets, we'll change the target data set to this teacher one. And then as far as the prompts that we can see of the generated images while it's training, you can set those as you want. So let me go ahead and do that. I'm going to just basically create 2 prompts that we can test out here. All right, those prompts are set. So all I need to do now is just simply click on create job. So if I go over to the training queue here, we'll see the job here and then we can press on play and then click start, and it will go through the process of training all the images. I found that with an RTX 5090, it roughly takes about an hour or so to generate a LoRA at 3000 steps with all the default settings. And once a job is complete, as we can see here, if you click on samples, you can see how the model started to learn the concept over time. So here's the original prompts with the LoRA not really being applied. And as you can see, the characters slowly morph into my teacher illustrated here and looks pretty good. So now we can actually download this file. So if I go to overview and then to the checkpoints here, you can download this latest checkpoint and then use it within your workflows. So as you can see, I have the LoRA loaded here and I have a slightly different trigger word, but it's the same exact data set and settings as I went over just previously. But you can see it's a school teacher shooting a basketball, smiling, and the output looks phenomenal. So that's it with training a Z-Image Turbo LoRA. Now, if you have any questions, please drop it in the comment section below. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.